Satnam guys, welcome to my channel. This is going to be a pick-up-all reading to see what message do you need to hear today. Okay. We have four piles to pick from as usual. For pile number one, we have this little piece of Palo Santo. To see what your message is this time round, what you need to know. For pile number two, we have this piece of candle wick, okay? It's covered in wax. This is actually a magical piece of candle wick, okay? So it's necessary for you to know that. It's a part of creation. Ooh. For pile number three, we have this beautiful little piece of black tourmaline. I got this just yesterday. Wow. Absolutely powerful energy. And then, for pile number four, we have this bottle of oil. I'm not too sure what oil is in it, but it smells almost like bergamot-y, okay? It's almost done though, as you can see. It's almost finito. Okay, so those are the four piles to see what is your message, what do you need to know currently in your life. Obviously timeless, 144, lekker. Pick your pile and I will see you there. Let's do two. Minute number dos in 20, shenak tanyinde. Satnam, pile number one. This is going to be your reading to see what do you need to know currently. What's the message from your spirit guides, your angels, your God, your highest, yourself, you know? I feel like you're going through some kind of natural progression of cleansing. I'm getting some kind of, like, with this natural vibe, I'm getting some kind of evolution energy. Like how bacteria evolve super quickly, or how, I don't know, perhaps nature evolved some kind of maggot to eat plastics only recently because there was a need for it, or something like that. I feel like your energy adapts very easily. It evolves very easily. It strengthens itself very easily. It cleanses itself very easily, okay? Very naturally, rather. It might not always seem easy. Let me rather say that. But it happens very naturally. It almost happens without you needing to do something. But if your energy is polluted, you do feel it. You know, like how you pollute a stream or a pond or a piece of land or something. Like, it takes quite a while for it to, like, restore itself, but it does eventually, no matter how hard you try to pollute it or whatever, okay? So there's something that you need to know about. Even if you chose to not do anything at all, your energy will naturally evolve, progress, your powers, your abilities, your whatever, okay, your consciousness. So let's see, what do you need to know? Pile number one, the Four of Cups. Yeah, interesting. Like, you literally don't have to do anything, right? Even if you just sat back and, quite frankly, rejected. This is very cool. Like, even if you rejected your own healing or your own empowerment or your own evolution or something like that, that would make your evolution even stronger, because it's kind of like literally life fighting against life in order to live. You know, it's like crazy shit. So it really doesn't matter what happens. Even, like, quite frankly, even if you yourself reject your own strengthening, your own ascension, that would just speed things up. I feel like this perspective is very important for you to know, because you might specifically sometimes struggle with this consciousness or this energy of, like, you need to do something or you need to heal or you need to blah, 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 blah. But again, your energy does that quite naturally, okay? Nee, wacht, ek werk. Bro. Ja, le. The Four of Wands. We have four here. So this is definitely very like angelic, high vibrational, okay? It's a very stable, high vibrational energy, just like nature is, you know? And I'm talking about like the natural world as in plants, okay? And stuff like that. When you connect with it, it's very serene, it's very tranquil, it's very high vibrational, very healing. And you don't even have to do anything to it. You can literally just leave it and it will be that. You can literally just leave a plant and it will bloom, you know? If it's like obviously in proper circumstances. But like that's a thing I feel like it doesn't matter where you are, it's always the proper circumstance, even if it doesn't feel that way. I have a feeling that after this reading, Paul number one, you're gonna go away with a very empowered, like perspective seed planted in your consciousness, in your blueprint, in your makeup. That's gonna allow you a lot of rest, not rest, a lot of celebration, a lot of rest as in not dealing with energy, not dealing with not feeling good enough, not dealing with feeling like you consistently need to heal, etc., etc., etc. Okay, you're about to like fully like rest into your own energy of easeless, of ease, not easelessness, of ease. What's the other word I'm looking for? Of strugglelessness, okay? Literally like evolution, like it literally created like the brain with billions of years of errors. That's what I'm getting. Like, it didn't even try. You get what I'm saying? It just did it, you know? Like, that's what I feel like you're about to step into that kind of consciousness, okay? The King of Cups. That is somewhat of an action card for me, though, because the King of Cups, because it's masculine, it takes action, it has a thrusting energy. But also because it's energy, it's much more flowy. Like, so it's kind of like you are able, this consciousness, this lack of inability to not progress is even flowing over into, even when you're not taking action spiritually, energetically, consciously, subconsciously, you're still taking action. You understand? The Five of Wands. Queen of Swords. Every place, Ten of Wands, Queen of Wands, every situation, every environment is the perfect environment for you. The Devil, the Lovers, Page of Wands, the Star, Nine of Swords, Knight of Cups, Five of Swords, the Empress, Two of Swords, the Sun. So this Five of Wands again is giving me that like evolve or die energy. Like you literally, even without trying, you evolve and you keep evolving to best your circumstance, to best your foe, your enemy, your environment, whatever, okay? If your energy or your soul had a superpower, it would be Darwin from X-Men, okay? And not the Darwin in the X-Men movies, because he was really done in and blah, 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 okay? Because his power is to literally be able to adapt to anything and everything, okay? Immediately. So maybe this consciousness that you are receiving now is actually rooting in to become much quicker for you, like you mastered evolution, you mastered survival of the fittest, okay, on every level of your being, okay, or you're about to such an extent where I feel like you're gonna realize you never actually even tried. It's like you never even tapped into the fucking top of the iceberg of your potential or your power, okay? And you're gonna realize, like, you don't have to, because, like, you don't have to try. Like, it's happening anyway, you understand? Yes. Okay. Ace of Swords, thank you so much, Paul number one. That was your reading. Please do consider liking, subscribing, donating, contacting me for a personal reading. Everything is in the description box down below, okay? I'll thank him for no one. Let's do 10-10 because I like it. Hello, ball number 2. You know, let's just cleanse your energy quickly to have new energy. This is going to be your reading if you chose this magical candle wick. Ooh, I feel like somebody's about to get a very magical or have a very magical experience. Like somebody, I feel like it's a woman watching me. I feel like I just like entered into your space. Like I feel like I was like just there, okay? Something might have even like bumped or went poof, or I don't know, a flicker or something. You know what I feel like is happening, pal number 2? I feel like you're about to have such a magical experience. It's gonna say, I feel like you're about to experience a miracle, but not a miracle as in like a miraculous healing or like you not missing a stop sign and avoiding a crash. Like I feel like you're about to witness. Interesting. I want to say like the parting of the Red Sea, but like I feel like it's much more personal for you. It's going to be much more, it's not some kind of global thing. It's like a very personal miracle that you're about to experience, okay? And because it's a candle wick, I feel like this is something that you generated yourself. You might have generated some kind of energy. Like I'm seeing a chi ball, or like the ball from, also a feather from Dragon Ball Z. Like you might have really snowballed some kind of manifestation or something. And it's not going to manifest the way you think. It's going to manifest in some kind of like actual light spark, or reality is about to bend or again for you. Okay, I feel like ball number 2, I feel like this is going to be something very new for you. I feel like you haven't experienced this level of energetic bending before, okay? And there's something about candles not being like natural, or candles being man-made. Again, there's like you created this energy, or you alchemized or manifested this energy, or you gathered this energy, okay? And again, like you think the manifestation is going to be some kind of man-made thing, or like a job or something like that. And that might be okay for you, but like you're not going to get that. You're getting something better. It's kind of like meeting God through man, okay? But it's not going to be just some kind of spiritual encounter. Like, I feel like you're about to witness magic. Or you are witnessing magic for some of you, okay? What's happening for ball number 2? The Empress, yes, there you are. I feel like I'm speaking and sitting with you, okay? Like, we're having a very proper even maybe when I say Kundalini awakening, okay? I don't feel like you're going to be having this experience with somebody or something, okay? Like, it's, again, not the presence or something. I feel like it's like telekinesis. Instead of you, like, healing, Reiki and stuff, you're literally going to be, like, the energy, you're going to be utilizing it as telekinesis. Ball number 2, what you need to know, your message is you are about to manifest telekinesis specifically, okay? I just also saw when I breathed out, I saw 10 of swords. I saw like the atoms of creation, the atoms of the universe, of the simulation or whatever, okay? The death and then the coming up into heaven again, you know? I feel like that's what you need to know. You're manifesting very proper, very intense telekinesis, okay? Not so bad. So, instead of you experiencing the body, the energies in your body, I feel, have I shared something like this before? It feels very familiar. This might feel like the telekinesis, might feel like something you've just always been able to done. I'm feeling a lot of like ancient Atlantean or Lemurian energy all of a sudden as well, okay? It's going to feel like you're just gonna know, like, I've always been able to done this, okay? Nine of Cups, yes. This Nine of Cups is very dreamlike, right? It's like being high or drunk or something like that, but it's also a wish fulfillment card. In order to change reality, you need to change the coding. And in order to change the coding, you need to, like, perceive the code with your consciousness and then will it to change. You know, the observer effect, etc., etc., the atoms, the quarks, the blah, 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 blah. I feel like you have mastered, or you're about to master, some kind of consciousness of, like, I want to say atom perception and atom rearrangement. This feels very powerful. This is goddess energy. This is proper goddess power, okay? And you might have utilized some kind of almost lack of magic in order to feel your magic. You might have utilized the disbelief that you can move things with your mind to charge your ability to move things with your mind. You understand? Utilizing science in order to empower you. Utilizing muggleness in order to charge your wizard or witchiness. Okay? Transfiguration is what I'm getting here. So, yeah, let's get the last two cards. The Eight of Cups. I feel like this is you. See, I feel like this is, that was your energy. That was your, like, reaction to, I don't want to say the world or the matrix, but that was your reaction to kind of like everything that is not this. Like, you're really walking away from, like, muggle reality. I just got an email. Compliments. Like, you're walking away from muggle reality. I feel like, you know what? I feel like you're not even walking away. You're being, it's kind of like you're being carried away. Or you're, like, flying away or something. A lot of telekinesis energy. Carried away on a cloud. Away from muggle reality. Or, you know what? It could even be into muggle reality here. Quite frankly. In order for you to, like, showcase your power. Not that you necessarily want to or need to, but, like, it's kind of like in the spirit world, telekinesis isn't a big thing, but in the 3D, it is. You understand? And you exist on all the realms at the same time anyway. Or all the realms exist within you at the same time anyway, right? So, yeah, I feel like that's what you need to know. I also feel like I just heard, like, a very specific name, but I didn't hear it, if that makes sense. I also feel like you need to, like, intend whenever you do some kind of energy work, even meditation, but, like, Reiki, for instance, or something like that, depending on where you're starting this journey. I feel like there's a very brand new energy here, but I feel like that brand new energy is the ability to move reality with your mind, okay? But whenever you even do, like, Reiki, you need to intend that you actually activate specifically your telekinetic abilities. Not just your metaphysical abilities, but your very physical abilities, okay? And again, like, utilize technology, utilize your phone. Like, a phone is a wand, etc., etc., okay? Like, utilize, I feel like, like somebody has already done this, and some of you are on this journey to doing this. Like, really utilize the dense physicality to charge your magic. Three of Cups, yeah. This is giving me some kind of coven energy. Ten of Swords, Queen of Pentacles, Seven of Swords, Three of Pentacles, Nine of Pentacles, the Lovers, the Sun, the World, the Tower, Death, Hangman, ha, all the way to the High Priestess, Judgment. Dionysus's aunt denied his mother that they said she lied, that she was bearing a god, that she was having the son of Zeus. Like, they denied Dionysus's divinity. And this, I also got something about, like, man-made when I was thinking about the man-made thing. I got something about wine as well. And again, the Nine of Cups is like changing the consciousness, whether you take shrooms, whether you meditate, whether you just utilize your will or whatever. I feel like there's about to be some kind of, like, to put that very, like, egoically or 3DE, like, I feel like you're about to put something or somebody almost, like, in its place. Some kind of retribution, like, oh, you thought I was crazy? Watch this. And then something happens. You do something. But again, I feel like it's much more personal. This might be, you might actually, there might be this kind of petty ish experience for you. I don't want to call it petty because it's actually not. Simply for you to receive some kind of closure or something. Either way, you're about to utilize telekinesis, like all of this air energy, to actually move things. Okay. Okay, poll number two. 133. Lekker. That was your reading. Please do consider liking, subscribing. Page of Cups, Three of Swords. Page of Cups is psychic abilities. Three of Swords, again, air energy, heartache, heartbreak. Literally using density against itself. Utilizing dense energy to move the dense energy, you understand? Very cool. That was your reading. Please do consider liking, subscribing, donating, contacting me for a personal reading. Everything is in the description box down below. Bye. Let's do 10. Satnam, ball number 3. For those of you who picked this lovely tourmaline, that was a lekker release. A very good release for me. So you're about to, I feel like you're about to be so protected from something that was like literally your hell. I feel like you're escaping hell now, or you're being dragged out of hell or something. I feel like you're just about to, I feel like all density is about to be released, okay? But like, in order for it to be released, you have to perceive it. All of your suffering, all of your troubles or something are about to be alchemized for you, or it is being alchemized for you. I'm also hearing something about misunderstandings or confusion, like you being confused, you not knowing who you are, disempowerment, etc., etc. Wow, I'm feeling so empowered by this black tourmaline. Like, I feel very empowered. I don't just feel protected, I feel empowered, okay? It's because I feel like a lot of the damage that you might have feel like you endured was literally you not recognizing your own power, right? So I feel like you're about to be very fucking empowered, pile number 3. There's some kind of, oh, fuck energy in regards to that as well, okay? I'm also hearing something about, like the gaslighting not working, mind games not working, because all of reality literally is just a mind game, okay? Everything is just projections, etc., etc. I feel like you've conquered a demon, or you've conquered your hell. Five of Wands reverse, but I'm taking it right side up. Like, yeah, I feel like there's a lot of energy surrounding you, a lot of very hectic, very intense energy surrounding you. But I feel like, it's interesting, like, I kind of feel this Five of Wands and I'm, like, aware of it, but my awareness is elsewhere. This that might have been like you might have felt like you were disassociating at some point, and like there might have been some kind of usage of your disassociation to continue abusing you, or to continue using you, or to continue draining you, or continue keeping you small or fighting. But I feel like this disassociation, I feel like you should go watch the collective I did yesterday. I think it was yesterday. Like, you were always above this devil or something. I feel like this disassociation energy that you went through was actually not disassociation. I'm seeing a bee. Rommel los om daar buig in jou steek hou. This disassociation was actually never you disassociating. It was you tapping into almost like, I want to say, the future of what you truly are. It's almost like skipping the, like, I'm not saying you didn't go through bullshit, but it's almost like you skipped 99% of the hell experience simply because you chose to kind of delve into it, okay? Just don't get me wrong. But you skipped 99% of the hell experience by disassociating. But it was never disassociating. It was protection, or it was actually your empowerment, your empowered self that was showing you what's actually happening. And I feel like now you're actually experiencing, maybe since you're on this like higher level now, you might be experiencing what was happening in the root levels, in the darkness, etc., etc. But I feel like you're about to see and fully feel and fully experience and embody this energy of like the fact that you are experiencing suffering or darkness means that you are literally above it already, because you've already grown out of it. This is a very powerful, I feel like, perspective that you're about to have, okay? This is very much all about your empowerment. Two of Swords, again, like you misstepped hell. Like, you experienced a percentage of hell, okay? But you misstepped it, like, the full experience, like, literally, because you chose to experience it for your healing or for your empowerment or something like that. You understand, right? It's almost like you chose hell here and heaven in the afterlife, let's say. I don't necessarily want to say morally, but like energetically or spiritually or something like that. Whereas the rich man, or the man that was always preaching and received the admiration in the world, already received his heaven. You understand? It's that kind of energy that I'm getting. Like, it's literally the last becoming first. Like, that's what's happening to you now. And like, again, it's like looking at your crucifixion, but you're recognizing, whoa, the only reason I'm witnessing my crucifixion is because I'm in heaven. Do you understand? What the fuck? You know, like, what? The Knight of Pentacles, okay. I feel like that is that black tourmaline energy. Like, again, like, yeah, like you're on this knight, you're on this horse or something. Like, you're not even part of the fight, actually. Again, like, you're not even being crucified. Like, what? Like, this, like, you, like, I don't know, you thought you were being crucified, or they thought they were crucifying you, or like, you witnessing the sacrifice, you witnessing the drama, you witnessing the rejection, the, I don't know what. You witnessing the suffering was literally you looking at it from heaven. And I feel like that's what you're empowering yourself with now. That's what you're, that's the understanding that's embodying in your reality now, in your core now, okay? Wow, right? Two of Pentacles. It's like juggling life and death, but like, You might have jumped in and out of a very high vibration, then a low vibration. Almost like with this high vibration, you understood what I just said and felt what I just said. But it's almost like you kept reassociating or something like that. But it's because you didn't recognize completely fully. You kept juggling this idea that, like, literally you witnessing the bullshit is because you are on a higher vibration. And the Six of Pentacles. Two of Swords, Ace of Pentacles, Knight of Cups, Ace of Swords, the Hermit, Nine of Cups, the World, Six of Swords, the Tower, the High Priestess. This is reminding me of, like, you know how Jesus screamed, "Father, why did you forsake me?" Well, like, Jesus was never crucified according to Islam, right? Like, because why would God allow his prophet or his, especially his son, to be crucified? Because he states in the Old Testament, "Don't harm my prophets." Right? So it's kind of giving this energy of, like, God just showing Jesus, or God just showing you, like, this. This is what they plan to do, or this is what the Matrix planned to do, this is what the devil planned to do, this is what Satan planned to do, this is what your shadow planned to do. So that's why basically I didn't allow that experience or this to happen, or I didn't allow your association or something like that, because if you associated, you would have gone down to hell. So again, like, this whole experience of you being sacrificed or you going through trauma, I feel like you're about to literally experience, like, you were experiencing that because you're already in heaven. So there's nothing else for you to do. This is about to be a very beautiful and, once again, empowering experience for you. This is kind of like God showing you, like, that's why you're not in hell or something like that, okay? Or showing you hell by having you experience that 1% and showing you, well, you're not going there. You understand? Because of this empowerment. Because you made the choice to experience hell on earth first. Or, like, you didn't give up your heaven in this life. You understand? This is very, like, yes. Okay, I feel like that's sufficient, pile number 3. That was your reading. Please do consider liking, subscribing, donating, contacting me for a personal session. Everything is in the description box down below. I'll see you again. Satnam, pile number 4. For those of you who picked this oil bottle, this is going to be your reading to see what you need to know. Let me just close this door, otherwise they're gonna trouble me. Akbar! Let me also get a cigarette, file number 4. So, I actually thought something about, like, an oil lantern. Okay? And I feel like me closing the door now, it's dark, 3, 4, 5, me lighting a cigarette. There's something about fire, something about the hearth, maybe. A hearth is the fireplace of the home. It's the heartbeat of the home, the spiritual heartbeat. There's something about warmth and maybe even, like, acceptance or something. There's something about creating a sanctuary or warmth or light or a campfire or a hearth in a very cold domain. In a very cold experience, in a very cold something. And because this oil smells very good, I feel like it's not just warm, but it tastes good as well. And it's not like smoke that's like and burning your eyes or something like that. So it's kind of like getting the best of both worlds. I feel like you're about to receive the best of both worlds. Interesting. I'm hearing the best of heaven and the best of the underworld. Now, by the best of the underworld, I feel like that just means the suffering you endured is the heaven you're receiving, right? Oh, wow. Ooh, okay. That came through quite clearly, actually. Seven of Swords, Three of Cups, Six of Cups, the Moon, Seven of Cups. I'm gonna tell them to be quieter if they're gonna be too loud, because damn. Okay, so but what we have here is we have the Magician, we have the Emperor, we have the Ten of Cups, we have the Four of Swords, we have the Four of Pentacles, and we have the Three of Pentacles. Ball number four, I feel like you, what is the Seven of Swords? I feel like the Seven of Swords is some kind of meticulousness, some kind of planning, some kind of escape even. It's kind of giving, you know what I'm getting with the Seven of Swords? It's kind of giving this, yeah, exactly. It's kind of giving this planning or this strategizing or this ability to alchemize with that Magician. That you are able, or you're about to be able, use alchemy to such an extent that, symbolically speaking, you're growing a diamond, or you're manifesting a diamond from nothing. Like how we utilize science, or how we utilized, I don't really want to call that science, how we utilized alchemy in order to make diamonds. I feel like that's what you're doing. And because of that ability that you... Justice, because of that ability that you perfected very meticulously, I feel like you're about to experience and perceive things beyond your wildest dreams. It would, like, it's kind of giving this energy of even making heaven. Your highest idea of heaven that you could have had, it's making that look like hell. It's making that look like the underworld. It's making that look like something not even worth your time. And that's also what I mean by the best of both worlds, because I feel like it's such an infinite upward movement into heaven, into your... Like, you alchemized heaven, or you're about to alchemize heaven, if that makes sense. Like a natural diamond is heaven, let's say. Whereas you creating your very own fucking diamond, because of this meticulous planning, this strategizing, this etc., 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 you bested heaven even. Literally... being able to create your own personal heaven exactly the way you want it. The Magician, the Emperor, Ten of Cups, Four of Swords, Four of Pentacles, Three of Pentacles. That's what you did, justice. Or that's what you're about to do. Or that's what you're doing now. Okay, that's what your journey has been about. So, why did I mention the hearth, or the home, or the fireplace, or the sanctuary? I feel like it's because, again, this hearth that was denied for you, or this heaven that was denied, or that you fell out of, or that you didn't want, or that you were sacrificed from, or I don't know, that somebody tried to steal from you, I don't know, this heaven is about to seem like hell to you. Because of the actual power and magnificence and wowness that you are creating, that you're like about to, that you're experiencing more and more with each passing day. Your divine justice, ball number four, death. Yeah, Ten of Pentacles, your divine justice is literally heaven as it was thought of being perceived as hell for you, because that's how amazing your self-created heaven is. Crazy shit, okay. Thank you so much, Paul number four. That was your reading. Please do consider liking, subscribing, donating. I'm seeing the Wheel of Fortune. No, the Hierophant. as well. Contacting me for a personal reading, and I'll see you again for another one, okay? Oh, I'm gonna rewatch this last one, because it felt so like, it felt very clear, but it almost felt like, whoa, like almost trippy, okay? Jesus. Okay.